Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? I'm going to carry on and I'm going to build some green science packs today so that we can continue with our research. I'd like to get oil so that I can make the advanced circuits, that is, the red ones. I tell you what, I really do struggle sometimes to remember the names of all the different items. You may have noticed, you may have sort of cottoned on to this one, but yes, I do kind of struggle sometimes to remember all of the names. I tell you what, that little bit of water just underneath us there, that could actually present a bit of a problem, eventually. At the moment it won't, I don't think, but I mean, obviously we're going to be moving later on anyway, we'll get well away from here and we'll be able to set out a huge great big base and change things around a bit. Now, for the green science, I'm actually going to direct feed the copper straight into the electronic circuit factory, and then I will may even direct feed that into the next one, which is going to be the inserter, just the standard inserter. I'll direct feed straight into that one. So I'm just looking, because we're on peaceful mode, we're not actually going to be that concerned about weapons. I mean, we will research all the weapons, just because, like I said last time, just in case the expansion, when it does come out, I think it's 1.3, is it? When it does come out, if they have changed the way that we can demolish the enemy bases, we're going to need some weapons if we're not able to use our turret system. I'm hoping we can use turret system, because that's a really easy way to do it. So I'd like to at least advance to being able to build turrets, so I need batteries and stuff as fast as possible, so that we can clear a few bases before that patch comes along. I think that would be quite beneficial to us if we could do that. So the green science packs will at least allow us to get oil, and we can get steel furnaces, that sort of thing, and then we'll be able to progress to blue science packs as rapidly as possible, and from there we can get the advanced oil processing, all the rest of it, and that will then sort of give us a slightly more efficient way of getting our batteries. I think the advanced oil processing is the best way forward, and once we have that, we will have the world. Well, what's the saying? The world is our oyster. Yes, so the world will be our oyster, or something like that. Anyway, I'm going to need to expand the copper production here ever so slightly, and to the south we do have a much bigger vein of copper, although we do have to remember that we've got several thousand. I mean, just that one there has got 20k available, 25k, and that's not covering everything, right? You cover everything, right? That's not a huge amount. I mean, 2.8 there. We will have to plonk one down right in the middle a bit later on, and you'll see how much we get from it, because you get masses of stuff from this. So like I was saying yesterday, I probably will progress to using some mods for this game, actually, because I do like mods to sort of accentuate the core game. I don't like to change the core game beyond all recognition, unless it's particularly good. It's got to be a particularly good mod for me to want to do that, and at the moment, from the mods that I've seen, mostly kind of just adding a couple of extra resources. I mean, I did actually say all of this yesterday, so I do apologize for repeating myself. I'm going to want some more furnaces there. I think we'll just go for standard furnaces and just put a few extra, because we're going to need a lot more iron. That is sort of the thing that holds me up. I remember this from the last time that I made a small base like this, or a base sort of like this, with the massive resources, is the speed that you get the iron right at the start. You really sort of need to increase that as rapidly as possible, and that's what can help you expand much faster. So I'll put out a whole string of furnaces in a little while. I want to get these green science packs being produced first. So we've got the electronic circuits coming in there, and then I've got the gear wheels and the iron plates coming in together, because I will take both of those into the inserters, and then the belt can move on, and I'll take both of those again to make the belts. It's the conveyor belts, just ordinary conveyor belts, aren't they? They're not anything else. So I'll use all of them. I've actually run out of coal down there, so everything was starting to slow down. That'll just keep me going for a little while. I'm going to need to do something about that. I think we will, later on, we'll put down some electric mining drills up there and sort of funnel the coal back round so we don't have to do it manually anymore. But that's that getting set up. I just need to actually just forgot to program in the conveyor belts. I'll just grab some copper a minute so that I can make a few extra things. Program in the conveyor belts there, and I need a couple of inserters. I need one more here to feed out the electronic circuits. And now, I tell you what, we want blues. We need all of this to go a bit faster. I'm also going to upgrade the factories as well, I think. I might not do it immediately, but if I put those two in the middle and feed them up, I get both of them together, so I'm getting everything all fed onto the same belt. And now I want a line of factories so that I can start producing green science. So I can actually run them on a belt to the left-hand side there of the factory that is producing the red ones. So I can keep the labs right where they are. I can put a few extra ones in and extend them down. So let's drop, I don't know how many we'll do. We'll do two. Actually, I think we'll probably end up, we'll do four of them, I should think. At least, well, three, maybe four. We'll sort of see how it goes and how the production of it is going, because that does seem to be feeding in okay. We're going to need some more iron, I think, to be able to keep up with it all. But the factories do seem to be keeping up with themselves at the moment. So that's good. I quite like that bit. Oh, yes. I do need a shotgun. Shotgun for removing the rocks. That's the one thing that is slightly irritating, is trying to get the rocks out of the way. It's kind of odd that the only way you can remove them is with the shotgun, and when you got all these other guns and that, but they don't do anything. You just need a shotgun. Well, in actual fact, a pistol would probably do more damage to something than a shotgun in real life, wouldn't it? I've got to be honest, I'm not that familiar with weapons, but I would have thought one slug out of a pistol would do more damage to something than a shotgun spreading shot across something. I'm from the UK, and we don't. Nobody has weapons. Some farmers have shotguns, and I did grow up on farms, but I never really had anything to do with shooting. I've done a little bit of shooting with a shotgun. I've never done any shooting with anything else at all. And I know that in many other countries, the rules are a little bit different as to what firearms you're allowed access to and what people use in different places. So let me know about that. Do shotguns do more damage than a pistol? Because I don't think they do, but I could be completely wrong here. I'm kind of guessing. Anyway, I'm extending this out so that I've got 10 of these. I will actually need to leave a gap there, won't I, for the telegraph poles. I want 10 of these, and then I will try and squeeze in 13 boilers, because that's kind of the optimal amount all the way through. Unfortunately, I don't need to worry about making sure that I've got power at all times. If I suddenly lose power, all I'm going to do is I'm going to lose production. I'm not actually going to lose defenses and suddenly get overwhelmed by a whole load of biters. That is the advantage of playing on peaceful mode. And I realise that some people actually do go for a full mega base whilst playing in a non-peaceful environment, but there's kind of a hassle I didn't want. I felt it would just be more pleasant all round if we could concentrate on building a huge base rather than building defences everywhere. Maybe we'll do this in the future. I'm not too sure. That's a long way from now. I'm actually thinking now I will get a few more labs. I've got one here. If I make a few more of them as well, I think we could have at least another 4 or 5 along there. And that's really going to push our early research really quickly. If I start researching as well some lab efficiency levels, I think that could really push it, because we're getting a nice bit of production here. We're not going to run out of ore anytime soon. The thing that's actually holding us back now, we got no iron plates coming through. The science packs are making as fast as they can, but it's these iron plates up here. That's what's holding us back. I've got two more labs ready to go. There's three. I'll make some more mining drills. It is kind of using up the mining drills nearly as fast as it's using up the ore from the mining drills nearly as fast as it's being produced. Same with the copper. That's not really progressed out very far. So I think we're going to need some more mining drills. And I'm hoping that if we get it right, we will actually use all of these furnaces. That is going to produce us a massive amount. So let's get rid of those drills, and then we'll pop this electric mining drill down here. I'm going to stick another one down next to it as soon as I've got enough iron. I'm now actually having to gather it off the belt. What am I going to research? Advanced electronics, that will help us. Gathering the iron off the belt, because we are using more than we're producing, which is a little bit of an issue at the moment. So if I get this coal going, this coal will actually, we can feed that straight into the belt where the ore is running up. And if it goes into the side, then we've got the coal and the ore being fed to the furnaces all the way up through. And that will sort of be self-sustaining then. And that little patch of coal would be enough, I should think, to last us until we actually need... we don't actually need it until we've progressed to electric furnaces. And considering that the only thing that's going to be holding us back is actually space rather than anything else, because the resources are not going to be holding us back, so we're going to be unlimited when it comes to a solar field. I'm probably where the desert bit is. If you look on the mini map out to the right hand side to the east, I would say that if we clear that huge base up through there, we could turn most of that into a massive solar field. I mean, really huge, oversized solar field. I think that's going to be awesome. And I'll probably stick with the pattern that I've already got. I don't know, I might play around with it a little bit. I quite like that pattern. I got to admit, I am quite partial to the one that I've done there. I did play around with it. I've had suggestions from a few different people about different patterns that I could use. I've had links to videos, and I really appreciate those. I have looked at some of them, and just because I don't use a suggestion doesn't mean I don't think it's good. I can't use everyone's suggestion, because I do actually get quite a few. So please don't be offended if I don't use your suggestion at any one time. I just try to use a variation on suggestions that I get and sort of experimentation with what I've learned myself about how the game plays. So if I drop this in, I'm going to actually want to put another conveyor down, because I'm going to need to feed a little bit of this coal down towards the boilers as well. I want to be able to fill everything up and not just the furnaces. I'm not sure if these two are going to be enough to produce the coal we need for all the furnaces as well. That's something we're going to have to check. So that's running down there. I'll feed underneath here, and then we can run down and round in a loop. Just go... I'm going to have to move these telegraph poles a little bit, move them out the way. And then if I just move them just to the top, that should still actually keep all of the steam engines all linked up, so then I can run the coal in here. I want to get a line of inserters. I don't actually have enough, and I don't know if I've got enough to make all of the inserters either. Let's just pop down some more telegraph poles so that we are all joined up. There we go. Everything is now connected up. I need more inserters now. I need more iron. This is where we start to slow down. Is gather. Oh, I've got some iron now. I've actually got plenty. I should have enough in that chest. Let's have a look. Yes, perfect. Right, now I can make a load of those. I can make some belts as well. So I can stretch everything out. I want to put the belt all the way along. Then I want to put the inserters as soon as they've made. Come on, hurry up. Gear wheels, there we go, inserters. Right, now I can drop those down, put them all the way along. You know what would help if I had these around the right way? Let's try that way. And now I drop down some telegraph poles, and that's power all the way through. Right, so now every single furnace is being fed, but I'm using up all the coal. I'm putting coal... I don't actually need that one in there, do I? I don't think I do. No, I don't, because the other two are close enough. I'll have to take that up in a minute. Move it out of the way. Now, see, the burner mining drills, they go straight into storage. It's like literally 20 minutes after you start on the map, you're chucking them into storage, you're not using them anymore. And incidentally, I did see a video the other day. I'm not sure where it was. I didn't actually watch the video, I just seen a reference to it. Someone has broken the record for launching a rocket on... They do it on peaceful mode. It was 2 hours and 5 minutes or something. They did it in 1 hour and 50... I think it was 58 minutes. 1 hour and 58 minutes. Something like that. But an hour and 58 minutes from starting, they launched the rocket. That is insane. Okay? That is absolutely insane. Look at all those bugs. We're going to have a lot of fun. Once we get the laser turrets, we can have some awesome fun taking that lot out. I'm really going to enjoy that. But yeah, how do you get to launch a rocket in just under 2 hours? I would guess you sort of kind of do what I've done here, except I've already been 40 minutes on this. We're now more than, well, 3/4 of the way through this episode. So we're at another 40, so I've been about an hour and a half, and I've got green science. So they obviously do things a fair bit different to how I do it. I'd have to watch their video, and then after watching the video, so sort of get some tips, see if I could do it. But I got to be honest, I've got no great desire to try and do that anytime soon. So I'm just going to change things around here a little bit. I might put out an extra mine or two, but I'm going to put down a couple of furnaces so that we get a little bit more copper being produced, so that we've got a nice efficient system. Should we go lab efficiency? Just trying to see what we should go for. We go for plastic. So yeah, we are actually going to need those. We want the advanced circuits fairly soon now. It's not going to be very long. We've got three things of oil right here. And I mustn't forget those. We're going to be using them. So if I drop the coal in on that side rather than the other side, then the ore can go this side. And now I can put some furnaces straight up here and run them up in a line just like that. Put a couple more of these up and run a belt all the way down there. Perfect. So now all I need to do is get some inserters and drop one up each side. I have actually only got those, and I don't have very much in the way of iron to make any more, but there's the copper flowing out. Grab some more iron, then I can make some more inserters, and I can make some lights as well. I gotta be honest, I didn't really like the night vision goggles that we were using, you know, where everything sort of goes a palish green, but now that we don't have them, I miss them. I actually missed them. I think I'm going to need to make another red science pack back there. It do seem to be using them up fairly quickly. But anyway, let's get another mining drill or two down. If I try and keep these reasonably even so that we're using them up at it, sort of squaring them off a bit. I like to try and use all of the ore up at around about the same rate. And I find that if you can put the mining drills down in a fairly even grid all the way across, it does tend to do that fairly well. So there's a couple more inserters. I got one more inserter. I can at least start filling up the furnace, even if I don't empty the furnace. And right, if we upgrade these at least to level 2 factories, it should mean that we're going to make our red science packs just a little bit quicker, because the green ones are on level 2 science packs at level 2 factories already. They're being made by the level 2 science pack. That the green science packs are being made by the level 2 factories. I'm getting a little bit confused. And I don't actually need the extra bit of conveyor switching sides for the copper anymore, because it's now being placed on the other side. They're coming down correctly. So we get an extra one of these in us, 4 for the red science packs. That should be enough. And I may even be able to squeeze in an extra a lab or two in a minute. I just want to put an extra couple of bits of conveyor up there. Right, those are working. And I need some wood. Actually running out of that. I miss the robots. I already miss the robots. That's the one thing that I really do miss. All my little buddies. Hundreds and hundreds of friends. But at the moment, when I go on to Robot Book, which is kind of like Facebook, only for robots, it's empty. I got no friends on there. So I really need to build some friends so that I've got plenty of people to talk to on Robot Book. Because Facebook's a little bit empty over on this planet. The bugs don't do it, and I get the reception from here back to Earth is terrible. Very, very poor. So I've just dropped the chest down there so that I got some surplus copper that I can grab, and I don't have to keep running up to the other end or clearing it off the conveyor belt. I think that would be an efficient way of doing it there. I could get some more ore coming up through here now. We're using up all the ore that we've got. So getting a couple more mining drills would actually increase that quite nicely. We're probably actually going to need to get faster conveyor belts very soon. I don't know how quickly we're going to need those. Just drop two down here. So I'll sort of keep it in a line, and then the little odd bit on this side that's left after this, I can start changing that afterwards. And I'll just start feeding that up through there. Ooh. Ooh dear. Yeah. I need the ore to stay on just one side of the belt here. How can I put this in so that it goes on to the correct side? I can't actually from there, can I? No. I'll have to do it back over here. If I can do it back down this side, I can drop one in there, and then it can feed onto the correct side of the belt. Drop it in there like that, and up that side. Pick those up. Pick everything up off of there, and switch that one round. There we go. Now it's all running on the correct side. And it's also running absolutely solid. It's just a completely solid line all the way together. But anyway, I have just about run out of time now. So if you enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give us a like. If you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.